Dr. Kimishima, the corpse is already here. Are you done?
Calm down, little guy. I said I'd leave in 10 minutes. It's only been 7.
Yes, but headquarters is telling me to hurry.
All right, I'll be right there. Goodbye.
Doctor, wait.
You shouldn't be allowed here. Do you need something?
Katie doesn't seem well. Can you fix her, please?
A cat? Why are you asking me?
Because you're a doctor, miss.
I... Hand it over. Looks like she swallowed something. She'll be fine.
Really?
It's common for cats to swallow foreign objects. Still, wait here for a moment.
Okay. Thank you, miss.
Thanks, huh? Right. Sorry I'm late. Is everything ready?
Dr. Kimishima, you're really late. You... Huh?
What are you looking at?
What happened to your hands?
A cat did it.
A cat? I never figured you for a cat person.
Be quiet. I thought you were in a rush here. Are we ready?
Right. I'll get ready now.
I see. So you were cut short, too. All right. I'll reel in the thread of truth. Explain the situation to me one more time, little guy.
Right. A skeletonized corpse was found in a river 50 kilometers out of the city. We don't know who it is, but evidence suggests it's female. A homeless man out walking his dog reported finding it. The preliminary cause of death is being ruled as a drowning.
Like you said, the body is completely skeletonized. We won't be able to ID her until we reform her skeleton.
I also have records from the questioning of the body's finder.
Huh, I'm impressed. For you, that's a brilliant move.
Please, that's not much of a compliment. I'll leave the recorder here. Check it when you need to.
Good. Let's begin. Show me how your life's thread was severed.
Oh, Dr. Kimishima, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Why are you calling for me on the intercom?
It's about the corpse.
Huh. I do have the corpse here, in a bag. Is this some kind of joke?
Oh, sorry, that was the most reliable way to get it to you. The skeleton had fallen apart, so I had them transported like this.
Huh, I see. So what am I supposed to do with it?
Please work on putting it back together. I'll start with the body. So can you please start restoring the skull, Doctor?
All right, I'll take care of that. Take a look. Looking at this skull, I'd place the victim's age in the early 20s. That's rather young. The bone structure suggests a high probability that the victim is female. I might find something out if I have the FBI analyze it in detail.
How's it going over there, Dr. Kimishima? I'm done with the body here.
Great timing. I just finished myself.
All right, I'll put the skull back with the rest of the skeleton.
Once that's done, let's begin investigating the corpse. This. The femurs of both legs have been fractured. The femur is the hardest bone in the human body. It would have taken a massive amount of power to break both of them at once. The little finger appears to be fractured here. What could have caused this bone to break? What's this? The bone's discolored? I've never seen anything like this before. I'll need a more detailed look at it. So was the victim run over by a car? Huh. That doesn't make sense, though, because the victim was... That's right. The corpse was found in a river. There may be some exceptions, but you usually don't find cars driving in the river. This. It's a bloodstain. However, it doesn't appear to have originated from a hemorrhaging injury. That's because... Yes. If this blood is from external injuries, then the clothing would be damaged as well. However, the clothes have no such marks. Could she have been hemorrhaging from some other reason? This is the necklace the victim was wearing. Is this stone agate? It's shattered in half. How much force would it take for this stone to break like this? In any case, this is unusual for a corpse that supposedly drowned in the river. little guy, I'd like to get your opinion on something.
Me? Well, I didn't think you'd ever ask me to...
Enough chit-chat. I'm transferring some data over to you.
Okay. What is this? Can you wait a moment? I'll compare it with the database here. It's as I thought. No matches. I've never seen this before. Not even at the place I used to work.
Huh. So does that mean you don't know the first thing about it?
I'm sorry, but that's correct.
Fine. At least I know now that there isn't any information. Hey, little guy. Can you do me a favor and get a bone analysis?
Yes, of course. Is it to identify the body?
Mm-hmm, that's right. Start with dental records.
I'll get right on that. I'll let you know when the results come in.
Yes, please do. All right, then. Fractures on both legs match the locations of the tire marks left on the clothing. That means these fractures were... That's right. These fractures in the legs appeared when she was run over by a car. How, then, did these marks appear on a corpse found in the river? This is a new mystery.
Oh, Dr. Kimishima, good timing. There's something I need to tell you.
Hmm? I'm listening. What is it? Ticks?
Yes, depending on the season and environment, various insects are attracted to corpses. They normally leave once the body's been reduced to the bone, but some ticks burrow underground and remain there for a while afterwards.
Hmm, true. They'll leave eventually as well, but perhaps the ticks could tell us something. Right. We could use the ticks to determine how long the corpse had been there.
Amazing, Doctor. I didn't think you'd know about that.
Mm-hmm. So, was the time of death calculated?
Yes, it seems to have only been about a month ago. That's not too long, biologically speaking.
A month? True, that is rather fast for a corpse to have been skeletonized. All right. Thank you, little guy.
Hey, can you see if they'll get me some of that Mooper's chicken, huh? Oh, this juicy fat drips out when you take a bite. Friend in the whole world. Don't be stupid. You want to know how I found that body? It's all thanks to Sam, you know? Yeah. See, we were walking down by the river when old Sam, he suddenly runs off and he comes back with a bone in his mouth. I took a better look and damn, if it ain't a lady's arm. It scared the hell out of me, you know? So I went and called the cops, huh? finding her? I mean, dead or alive, right?
Little guy, that man who found the corpse might be telling us one hell of a lie.
What do you mean?
In his testimony, he claims that he never saw the corpse, correct?
Yes.
Yet there is something he said that he couldn't have known unless he had seen the corpse previously.
There was? Wait, what was it?
Do I really have to point it out to you?
Yes, please.
He said that his dog had brought back an arm bone. Even for a forensic scientist, it would be difficult to determine the sex from just that. That means that the man who found the corpse is... He must have seen the corpse in person. He then made an assumption of the corpse's gender based on the remaining articles of clothing. Let's look at the information in detail.
Sure, but why would he lie?
A good question. Here's one possible explanation. He didn't want the authorities to know that he had been at the scene.
But it's not a crime to discover a dead body. Why would he try to hide that?
The most likely reason why he didn't want it to be known is... Indeed, because he tampered with the scene. It's likely that he did something that would get him in trouble if it was discovered.
Oh, I see. That would explain his behavior.
The question is, what did he do? Little guy, go interrogate him once more.
Trust me. I'll make sure he doesn't hold anything back from me this time.
That's all the information we can obtain from the corpse and other articles up to this point.
So, Dr. Kimishima, is the cause of death drowning after all?
No. There's a good possibility that the cause of death was something else. The damage to the skeleton is too severe for drowning to have been the cause. Her skull itself was... Yes, it was completely shattered. Even if animals had damaged the bones, they wouldn't have done that. Her skull was shattered by an extremely strong impact of some sort.
A strong impact to the head? That isn't consistent with a drowning.
There's more to it than that, though. During the autopsy, the corpse's femurs were... Right. The femur is supposed to be the most durable bone in the human skeletal system. However, both her femurs were completely fractured. This also suggests that some kind of powerful impact had occurred.
I see. Also, in the area where the corpse had been found, the water level was low, and there are no waterfalls, rapids, or records of floods. There's nothing in the river itself that would cause such damage to the corpse.
Yes, but that's all we know for now. It's risky for us to assume anything beyond that. Little guy, get approval from HQ. I'm heading out to the actual location.
Wait, are you going down to the river?
No. She didn't die in the river. The evidence we have suggests the actual place of death was... Right. This location is the most likely place.
Understood. I'll make arrangements for us to go right away.
Yes, please do so. Now, let's head out. This piece of stone isn't a natural shape. Somebody had to work on this. I feel like I've seen something similar recently. Long skid marks and signs of a collision. What do these tell us? It's apparent that a car accident happened here. Shards fit perfectly. That clears something up for us now, and that is... Yes, the victim was on the bridge where the accident occurred. There's no conclusive evidence of how she died yet, but this may be a clue. Little guy, does this information tell us anything?
Give me a moment. Let's see here. Blue paint thought to have come from a vehicle was found on the area of the collision along the guardrail. Investigating what kind of vehicle it's from, but that could take some time.
So this means that a blue vehicle ran into the guardrail here. Any other details?
Well, we can use the skid marks to determine how many tires the vehicle had. It seems this vehicle had two wheels on the front axle. Behind that, there were two more axles, both with two tires on each side.
That means there were 10 tires total. Judging from the number and positions of the tires, it must be... Yes. The pairs of tires are for dispersing the weight of the load it's carrying. Thus, this vehicle is designed for transporting heavy shipments.
I see. I'll get in touch with the investigators about this.
Please do. Hopefully they can use this to find other things. There's no doubt that the victim had been run over in this case. If the victim had been killed in this accident, how long ago did the accident take place? Right. The victim died about a month ago. If the victim did die from the accident itself would have taken place a month ago as well. Yes. There's evidence that the victim had been on the bridge when the accident took place. There's evidence of having been in a car accident in the victim's body and clothing. That evidence is... Yes, that's right. Taking these two facts into account, it's quite likely that the victim was in an accident at that place.
Dr. Kimishima, we've identified who the body was.
Great. Was there a hit in the dental records?
That's right. The victim here is Veronica Cage. She was 23 years old. It seems she was living with her parents 8 kilometers from where the accident took place.
I see. We're making progress. Has the family been notified?
Yes, that's been done. There was something odd about it, though.
Huh. What's that?
The parents hadn't submitted a missing persons report, though their daughter had been gone for a month.
You must have had a happy childhood, little guy. Every family has its own problems.
Questioned them just in case. The interviews were recorded. If you need to listen to them, check the voice recorder.
All right. Anything else?
One more thing. About the man who discovered the body. Like you thought, it looks like he tampered with the crime scene. We interrogated him again, and he's currently being detained. You can use the recorder to listen to that interview as well.
All right. I want to know what he'd been doing there.